Look at all this booze Buzz got me for Christmas. I'm rich. I'm rich with booze.
What's that? To Buzz from Dickel. Aww. What a sweet little guy. He does like me. I knew it all along. I'm gonna open this, Dickel. This is just so sweet. Really, from the bottom of my heart, a Merry Christmas to you, Dickel.
Merry Christmas, Buzz.
I can't wait to see what you got me. Oh, you got me beer! My favorite cheap beer. Wait a second. This is awful light for beer. These cans are empty! What the?
What? Those cans are worth 5 cents apiece. You got a lot of money there.
Of all the cheap, low-down, dirty tricks, this takes the cake.
Cheers! That's good beer.
Well, Happy New Year, everybody. Today's New Year's Day. One thing when I was a kid, every year we had to watch this Rose Parade here. And that's what you're watching there. And I never understood it very well. I guess it was just boring to me. But we used to watch it every year. And get this. We had a black and white TV. What's that all about? You couldn't see any colors. Old Buzz has been sick the last 3 or 4 days, right after Christmas. He either has a great immune system and he had the flu and it only knocked him on his ass for 2 days, or he has a very weak immune system and just a lousy little cold knocked him out for 2 days. But anyway, I'm here. And I plan on doing this radio and record player.
Hot damn!
Let's just zoom out a little bit. You've seen this on the last video.
I remember Squeak Straw.
There it is, in all its glory. This is a 1950 Admiral Model 6S12 radio / record player. And in this episode, we're going to take a close look at it. And if everything looks okay, maybe we might even power it up. On the left side, we have the on-off switch. This is a tone here. On the other one is the tuning. Radio tuning. One that says phono. And one says radio. There's a little light there. I don't know if that's an on light or if it's a record light. That is a mechanism that probably holds the records. So when they drop, these things move in. But it's strange to me because I've never seen such a contraption before. All right, there's the tone arm and the little switch. Now, if we look at it, from the left side, it says a 7, a 10, and a 12. And on top of the 10, it says 33. So that's probably 33 and a third. Then the other side says standard, then 12 and a 10, and a 45. So I don't think this has got 78, unless I'm completely blind. I don't see a 78 switch on there, but maybe when they say standard, they're talking about 78 standard, and then if you're using a 45, you just move it to the 45 position.
Yes.
I don't think it. I know it must be.
We won't find out until we take this all apart and start playing with it. There's the tone arm. And if you notice on this record player, there's no tone arm rest here, so I'm thinking maybe it doesn't have one. Maybe that's the position where it just sits and stays. Because I don't think this is an auto shutoff record player.
I don't know, boys. I just don't know.
Let's see if this has a cartridge in it, okay? Looks like there is some type of a cartridge in there.
Boy, look at that.
It's got like two feet here. Maybe that's just the rest on it. But I don't see a needle in there. I don't even know where a needle would go. Unless it would go in here. I've taken it out and it says Sure, S-H-U-R-E, crystal pickup. Where the hell is the needle supposed to be? The needle's supposed to be here? Why is there a screw in there?
It's obvious you don't know anything.
It's got Admiral on it. I found some of this stuff in the top here. There's a bunch of pieces of it. There's a few more in there.
Huh?
Looks like that's maybe like a ferrite rod or something for the antenna.
Hey, come on, move it, pal.
Flip around something.
Well, I'm tired. If I have to die, I'd just as soon die in bed.
It's right side up here. Holy mackerel.
Holy moly!
Well, it looks like I found my antenna where the stuff goes in there. I wonder if that stuff's any good, if it's cracked.
Who knows?
Not me, Mr. Roper.
There's the sticker, Admiral Model 6S12N. Looks like there's one, two screws here, and there's two on the bottom. Might be able to take this out. There's the cord.
Good Lord.
You've got multiple splices. Good Lord.
Oh, good Lord!
That's crumbling. I'm gonna see if I can take this out.
Pull it out!
And get a closer look at it. I got the screws off. Let's see if I can...
Well, take it apart, pull it out.
Oops, remove this.
Let's see here.
Let's see, what's in the news today?
Being held up. There it goes.
That was easy!
Everything's okay. Go back to bed. It's late.
Looks like one of the little mantle clocks there, by the shape of it. Oh, this is Rusty.
Rusty? May I call you Rusty?
That's what old Buzz needs, another rust bucket.
If you got something really stubborn, I would say use naval jelly. But for the most part, use the Evaporust or the WD Specialist rust soak. That's it, folks.
Speaker's intact.
Cut the cord.
Cut this disgusting.
That is disgusting.
Power cord there. There you can just see the rubber is just gone. Let's take this tape out.
Well, gee, it must be pretty rotten by now.
That's the further motor on the changer.
Now things are beginning to make a little sense.
This is the cartridge wire. Matches to see what that looks like.
Beautiful, graceful, elegant.
Let's take some bets here. Who thinks it's going to be virgin inside there?
Eh? Are you a virgin?
I beg your pardon?
How many thinks it's been worked on? Oh, everybody's hands goes up. Okay, that's the consensus. Spunny's been in here. And we'll see what their handiwork looks like.
Hurry up! Aren't you finished yet?
Alright. Are you ready, ladies and gentlemen?
Yes, yes, of course.
Ladies and gentlemen, look at Kong, the eighth wonder of the world.
Right off, I can see that this is the original electrolytic, but looks like somebody put in a bunch of electrolytics here. They haven't cut any of the wires on the electrolytics. They just got these three strung in series, and these two here strung in series. 350 microfarads in series will give you a total of 16.6. And these are only rated at 50 volts here. So he probably added these because this 30 here was weak. Same with the other. I'm going to remove this mess. Temporarily put in a 230s and a 20.
Then do it.
And we're going to power this thing up. Let's cut this. This will be the 30 one.
30 seconds to impact.
And this is the minus. I'll just hook those in there. This will be the 20. I'm gonna hook that in there. I just soldered that mess.
Wouldn't do that. Not unless I knew which wires were what.
Wrong one. How many caught that, huh?
I did.
Oh, you're sleeping, I see.
What?
Wake me up in 154 hours.
And I'm going to cut the yellow from there. And the red. This is the 15. This is a 20. I'm going to tack that in here. Until you get sick, sometimes you don't really appreciate how good it is when you're feeling normal and well. So I'm gonna appreciate when I get better how good it feels to be in good health and be able to breathe.
Amen.
Although I don't look it, I walk.
Oh, brother.
2.5 miles every day. I have done it for 2.5 years. And it actually changed my life. I was a wreck a couple years ago. It takes me 45 minutes, so.
Huh?
I recommend everybody who has got asthma or anything, start walking. Okay, that's enough of my preaching here.
Get off your soapbox.
Okay, there's a blue one here. That's supposed to be 20. Okay, I added a third cap here. Put the box on. And pump up the variac here. 30 volts. 60.
You smell something?
90.
You smell something?
We're getting something now. I don't know what that's supposed to be. Holding steady around 89-90.
Steady, trooper. Steady.
This one is rated for 160.
Listen. You hear anything? No.
Now all the controls there on the bottom and I got these gator wired in here. I'm going to try to get this done so I can flip it over and see if we can get the radio to work with some 90 volts on the B+. Okay, I hooked those other two caps up and I got it upright here so we can see if we can tune it. So turn this up and just put this up here right to about 110. Just watch the B+ go up.
What's that noise?
Popcorn.
You're making popcorn?
Uh-huh.
That lamp actually works. It's all dirty and it still works.
Hey, Alan, you think I can have some of your popcorn?
Yeah, sure.
The two caps I replaced it with are a little bit higher. So it's now about 120. My local station, that's 10 miles from here. I see these ferrite material, I think it goes in here.
Primary care quality means choosing to have a personal relationship with your doctor, to have an ally, someone who knows your entire family. I've met some truly amazing physicians here who could work anywhere else. They're here because of the connection.
It did make it go up a little bit though. The rust on this tuning cap is terrible. See if I can get my broadcaster on here and to fix up that. Let's just listen to a little Doris Day here. This is gonna sound pretty scratchy. This tuner is not working that great, but let's see what we got here.
Forever,
So this is going to take a lot of work to get the rust off and recap all this. Next week we're going to concentrate on the record changer. We're going to take it apart and oil it and stuff and see if we can get it to work. In the meantime, I'm going to find out about what type of cartridge I can use in there. And hopefully we can have that in the next couple of weeks and we can play a record on it. Sing it, Doris.
Okay.
Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you in the next episode.
I love you, baby.
I love you, too. Good night, darling.
See you.